Now, from across the tri-state, this is KHQA Sports.
Well, it is the single most critical element in the success or failure of any relay team. And yet for Rushville Industries fast rising squads in the 4x1, the 4x2 and the 4x4, the concept of the exchange has taken on a connotation that goes beyond just sports. And it starts with Rylan Hinnick and David Buckner.
I mean, me and David, you know, have amazing chemistry with getting that handoff. And I mean, we've got a lot of trust on the team. We've got a lot of trust with each other.
It's pretty awesome. We got a pretty good team. I mean, everybody worked pretty hard, so I like that.
I don't know, it's been phenomenal how we trust each other and how well we can perform.
The symbolism at play in the act itself isn't subtle. But for Rushville native Rylan Hinnick and his three African-born teammates on the Rocket Sprint Relay squads, the passing of a baton is purely functional because there is, in fact, a race to be won.
You know, 2 years ago, we had a really good 4x1 team, and then when, you know, it was loaded full of seniors, and when they graduated, thought, man, what are we going to do? And then we came back the next year, and these guys helped out. You know, Rylan Hinnick starts for us, and then it hands off to David, and the hands off to Gideon, then to Bazil, and shoot, we came back, and we were faster the next year, and we, you know, it kind of surprised us all, but they've done, they help us an incredible amount.
Just how it is that a typically insular farming community in West Central Illinois becomes both home and safe haven for kids born half a globe away is a story with its own unique inertia.
Quite a few years back, we had some kids, you know, some families move over from Africa. You know, they were seeking religious freedom. They found work in Beardstown and ended up being, you know, they chose between Rushville and Beardstown on where to live, and a lot of them chose Rushville just because it's such, you know, it's a nice place to live and it's very quiet and not a lot of trouble that goes on there, so it was a good place for them to raise their families. And from over the years, I think word got back to over there, and they started coming over more families at a time.
That surprised me too. I mean, one day we show up to school and we got kids coming in from, you know, we got told that they're coming in from, you know, the Congo and all that, and I don't know, it's just crazy to think that Rushville, Illinois, out of anywhere they can go, they pick, you know, that's where they ended up at.
It's pretty quiet, I can tell you that much, but I got new friends, things have been better. I mean, it didn't start off as easy, but still, though, it got better.
I don't know French very well, so, but it's good for them, you know, they learn English really well.
I had to read a lot of books, watch a lot of cartoons, and spend a lot of time with other peoples, just to get around the language.
You learn a lot of things about, you know, the culture and how they're raised and how they do things, and it's really interesting, and it's a lot of fun. The kids are great, and I have a good time with them all.
They enjoy doing what they do. They enjoy school, surprisingly. Most teenage guys don't. Yeah, they're really good kids in the community, and I love being a part of a team with them.
Do you feel like part of the family, part of the Rushville family now?
I do. That's the reason why I'm still in Rushville. So it's a pretty good school. It's awesome.
Pretty awesome stuff indeed. By the way, Zach Royer currently has 5 Congo-born kids on his current roster and lots of young brothers and sisters still to come and families on their way. Should be some good stuff for years to come for Rushville Industry. And we'll have more news for you coming up after this.